Hi everyone, it's Doreen, and today we're back with day three of Christmas cards with the Cricut. This is the card we're going to be making, so let's get started. Okay, the cardstock that we're going to be using to make this card is by DCWV, and it's called the Holiday Collection, the Christmas stack, and it looks like this. And I purchased this last year on sale at Joann's. So, okay, our card measures 4 1/4 by 11, and I'm gonna take my score pal and score this at 5 1/2 to make the card 4 1/4 by 5 1/2. So let's score this real quick. Get a nice crease in there. I really love the score. I keep calling it the score pal because I do have a score pal, but this is actually the score buddy. So, and I also have the Martha Stewart one too. Okay, so let's move on. Okay, the next thing I did was I took some glitter paper that I had and I used my ribbon loop Martha Stewart punch, and I punched out this piece right here, which looks like this, and we're gonna tape this down or glue this down, and I'm gonna use my two-way zig pin again to glue this down. I found that running it through the Xyron when I did the other card gave me a lot of stickiness that I didn't want. So I can do this real quick and just run it through using a zig pin. And the zig pin does stick really well, so I don't have to worry about it coming up. So I just run it across one way and then run it across another way, and then I do the loops down at the bottom here as well, so that I can make sure I get it all glued down. And then I'm just going to take it and pick it up and glue it right down here at the top, and then just press down. Okay. And then the next thing I did was I cut another layer using the ribbon loop punch by Martha Stewart, and I laid that down here at the bottom going this way. And I left a little space down here because I wanted to put my greeting. So once again, I'm going to glue this down real quick. Probably should have got, I have a bigger two-way. I probably could have gotten that one to glue down that bottom piece. But this won't take that long to glue. And then like I said, I just went across like so. And then I went across going back the other way. Got to make sure you can get in all those crevices because you don't want it to come up. And a two-way glue pin works really well to make sure things don't come up. And I'll put a little bit more just to make doubly sure. And then I just take, and I'm going to open this up, and I lay that down across there. Now I noticed I did have a little edge piece here, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my Tim Holtz scissors and just snip that going across so that I have an even edge there. And it looks like that. Okay, the next thing I did was I took my Sizzix dies, and it's the scallop oval. They look like this. And I took the larger one and then the next size down and ran those through my cuddle bug. And once they were cut out, I took my cuddle bug swirls folder and which looks like this. And I ran that through the cuddle bug. And then what I did was I took my Tim Holtz sanding tool and I just roughly sanded over the paper that I use. And this paper is some of the Paper Studio textured cardstock. And I just ran that lightly across on both pieces. Now this piece right here is a little different color than the piece that I have on the first card. And that's only because I didn't want to cut another large piece of cardstock from the Paper Studio textured paper. And I just used some scraps that I had left over to do this piece. So after I sanded it, I did take and use my Tim Holtz Distress Peeled Paint ink and did my edges. And this is what I came up with. So then what I'm going to do next is I've got some foam tape on the back. So I'm just going to peel off my foam tape and I'm going to adhere the bottom layer to the card. And I'm going to place it right there in the center and adhere that down. And then I'll take my next piece, and I have some foam tape on the back as this as well, and I'm going to add that on top of this one, my bottom layer. Now for my stocking, the stocking was cut from the Christmas card cartridge, and it doesn't actually have a handbook, but it does look like this, and it's this stocking right here. I cut this one and then I cut the one below, and those were cut at 3 inches for the top layer and 3.35 for the bottom layer. I did those on the Cricut. I found when I cut the shadow or the bottom layer at 3 inches, it was too small. So what I ended up doing was taking and zooming in for the top layer and then laying the bottom layer on top of it. And I just kept widening it till it fit perfectly. And then as you can see at the top, once again, I used some of that liquid applique. I'll zoom in so you can see that. To make it look like fur. There we go. And then what I used, like I said, was the liquid applique pen. I painted it on and then I let it dry overnight, and then I took my heat tool and heated it till it became puffy. So now I'm going to put that on top of my scallop circles, oval circles. And I have some foam tape again on the bottom or the back. And I'm just going to lay that right on top. Now the other thing that I did as well is inside the pieces of the stocking, I took some of the Yasutomo watercolor paints and painted inside there, and I painted the little stem on the edge there. And then the last thing I did was I cut out a piece of cardstock, and this cardstock measures 2 3/4, and I stamped the word joy, which came from an Inka Dinka Doo stamp set that I have. And once I stamped it out, I took my corner rounder or corner chopper, the 1/4 inch side, and I rounded my corners. And then I took some more of the Yasutomo watercolors and I painted the joy and the swirls just to give it that glitter effect. So I got some foam tape on the back of this as well. So I'm going to go ahead and take that off. And then I'm going to adhere that to the front of my card. Now, for the inside of the card, I once again took my Stamp-A-Majig and I stamped out, "May the simple joys of life fill this special day and be yours throughout the coming year." And that is also from a Stampin' Up! Seasonal Greetings from 2002. So there you have it. There's day 3 of Christmas with the Cricut. Thanks for watching, everybody. Bye.